If you go through this museum, you come out feeling very hopeful. You see that people have power. Individuals have power. They can change the world around them. It's hard to do by yourself, much easier to do in a group, and if you get together with other people, you can change things. And we tell that story over and over in this museum. History might not repeat itself, but man does, and woman, people do. And so what we can learn from the historical example that we tell here is how a group of people managed to change their world and really change the entire world, because what happens in America is often repeated in other places, for good and for bad. Historically, the United States has been the biggest champion of human rights around the world, and human rights defenders in other countries have always relied on America to be their champion. And that's at risk right now. America is not standing up for human rights around the world. And so that will have a negative domino effect in other places where human rights defenders are not protected as much as they were. And so anyone who comes to this museum can see, especially largely our visitors are American, can see the role they play not just in our own country, but how important it is to make sure our government respects human rights so that people around the world are protected. As the world around us feels very chaotic, places like history museums are where you can go to feel a little more centered. These times feel really unique to us, but the past has many lessons for how people overcame adversity in their country and in their civic life and in how people dealt with each other. We're not the first to go through this.